Hey everyone, welcome to another bonus episode of The New Marketing Show, the marketing podcast where we talk about how effective digital marketing and web development solve business problems. So today let's talk about content and your content strategy and the best part about having a content strategy. So the best part about having a content strategy is it's going to afford you some opportunities to do things that otherwise you couldn't really be able to do. So if you're speaking a lot on certain topics and certain industry matters, what it's going to allow you to do is it's going to allow you to tap into your audience in different manners. It's going to allow you to do some retargeting. It's going to allow you to start running some Facebook ads or Instagram ads. It's going to allow you to put a pixel on your site when people come in. You know, you can retarget them throughout the web. It's going to give you the opportunity to reach people in the best way that where they want to be reached and how they want to be reached, and just to make things work for them. Remember, they're your audience and they're the ones really driving, you know, the content machine. So you should always be in tune with what they want, and you can figure that out really easily by the questions that they ask you and, you know, your Google Analytics, what pages are coming to more and more frequently. But once you get all that stuff in place, you can serve up content and repurpose it and broadcast it and just have a whole arsenal of things. One of my favorite things to do with content is whenever a client, prospect, or somebody I'm trying to mentor or help has a question about a certain topic, and if I know that I already created a piece of content about that, I love sending them the link and I love just showing them exactly, hey, this is how we did it, this is how you can do it, and this is, we practice what we preach, and we're not making this shit up. This is exactly what we do. So that's the beauty of having a strong content marketing plan and a strong content calendar and just making things happen. Now look, it's a lot of work, but it does scale if you allow it to. Make sure you're putting the right people in play whenever possible. Make sure you're using the right services, and you know, your budgets and your needs will dictate that. And all of that stuff will really help you elevate your game over the lazy people in your industry. You can totally tell a lazy marketer versus an ambitious marketer by the amount of content they produce, their reach, and how they're perceived as a subject matter expert. So thanks so much for watching. Thanks so much for listening. We will check you out later. And thanks. You can always subscribe to our show on iTunes, Stitcher, Podbean, iHeartRadio, Spotify, all those good places. So thanks for your support. Talk to you later.